The following components are included in the scope of delivery of your Epsilon Plus dielectricity meter. First of all, you have your electronic box, as well as the sensor with the stainless steel screw-on sample cup and a heat-resistant adapter sleeve. For automatic temperature control of your samples, you have a dry block thermostat. Of course, there are mains cables for the power supply of both of these devices. The red and black cable can be used for connecting the Epsilon Plus to the thermostat. To connect your Epsilon Plus device to your laptop or personal computer, you will find the PC cable. If no serial port is available on your computer, use this serial to USB adapter. Last, there is a glass cylinder to help you fill in your 8 mL samples into the sample cup. In order to connect the sensor to the Epsilon Plus device, plug in the large plug into the sensor socket with its wider side up. Use the additional screws to tighten the connection. After this, please connect the Epsilon Plus to the thermostat. Use the black and red cable and note that this is the thermostat plug, while this is the plug for the Epsilon Plus socket. Again, use the screws on both sides to fix the connection. Now the other ending of this cable should have its tiny metal pin facing downwards, before you plug it into the thermostat. Use the cap screw on this plug to tighten it as well. Next up, take the data cable with the PC sticker on it, which marks the computer side. So this is the plug that goes into your Epsilon Plus device. Once again, use the two screws to fasten the connection. Finally, use the first mains cable for power supply of your Epsilon Plus. And the second cable to plug it into your thermostat. Now, your devices are ready to be switched on. If there is no serial port available on your computer or laptop, you may want to use the serial to USB connector for adaptation. Make sure that you plug it into the USB port of your computer first. Its driver must be installed correctly before connecting the Epsilon Plus. You can check this by means of the device manager on your computer. Next, you connect the USB adapter to your PC cable. Now your Epsilon Plus dielectricity meter is connected to your computer and you are ready to prepare for measurement. First of all, unplug the sensor cable from the sensor. In order to do so, simply pull it up, but please do not turn the plug. Now, pull the sensor out of the heat-resistant adapter sleeve. Next, you can unscrew the sample cup, which also functions as the outer electrode, from the sensor head. Be careful with the last turns of the thread and make sure you hold on to the cup once it's loose. set the sensor aside carefully. Make sure that you do not touch it, so its sensitive surface remains dry and clean. Now grab the cup and fill it with 8 milliliters of your sample. Decant your fluid slowly from the glass cylinder in order to avoid any entrained air in your sample. Make sure that the cup is filled without dripping on its inner thread, since this may affect the measurement. Turn the cup slowly to distribute the sample evenly. Now grab your Epsilon Plus sensor head and immerse it gently into the sample. Screw on the cup with slow and steady turns. Once the cup is screwed on tightly, mount the heat-resistant adapter sleeve, which adapts to the inner diameter of the thermostat socket. Last, you want to reconnect the sensor cable. Find the red mark on both the plug and the socket and connect the sensor by a gentle push. You may now insert the sensor into the thermostat. After approximately 1 minute, the first measurement values will be displayed on the LCD of your Epsilon Plus meter, including temperature, electrical conductivity, permittivity, and the DDF. You are now ready to use the Flukon software for automatic measurements and sample temperature control. Make sure that you copied your Epsilon Plus program to a directory with full administrative access. Now click on the program icon to start the software. This error message will only appear upon initial start of your program. It wants you to configure the correct serial port for your Epsilon Plus device. To select the respective COM port, simply click on Options, then Serial Port to select your COM port. Use the Device Manager if you are unaware of the correct port number. This is what the program window looks like. Start a measurement by clicking on File or on the empty sheet symbol. Now this screen will pop up, asking you to fill in a fluid name for your sample. Next, you can select your mode of measurement. Select temperature interval for your automatic temperature dependent measurement. Now type in your temperature settings, such as the start temperature of your run, which should be above your actual temperature, the end temperature of your run, which should be below the flash point of your substance, as well as the temperature increments. Please note that only one value is determined at each of these temperatures. If you're looking for multiple values, use the discrete temperatures mode. Eventually, click on Start to run your measurement. The remote control of your thermostat will now be activated and you will find the first row of your protocol displayed in red until the sample reaches the start temperature of your choice. Notice that the bottom of the program window has a status line which not only includes information about your active COM port, system number and measuring mode, but also your temperature settings. Please note that measurement of dielectric properties requires thermal stability, so your patience may be required as well. Depending on your sample and temperature settings, Epsilon Plus measurements can take up to 14 hours. When your measurement was finished, a message will be displayed within the program. Click on OK and you will be given the option to save your protocol to a directory of your choice. After clicking on Save, you are given the opportunity to add a comment, which may include further information on your sample or measurement. Congratulations! Your Epsilon Plus measurement has now been saved, and you can now either close the program or start another measurement.